visor
Sankarshan, on some issues. Sankarshan, let's get all points in.
I was just trying to quote an authority on Jammu and Kashmir. I was shouted down by the editor of...
No one shouted, sir. I can't shout down you.
Yes, Pinky, complete your point.
I am only making one simple proposition. It is the admitted position that the BJP has been taking the stand that Article 370 needs to be considered. We are doing that consideration. Now, what possible objection anybody can have but the ensuing elections to make an entire song and dance about it, to say as if the same is being revoked at the present point of time? And secondly, as far as the constitutional history is concerned, I wish some of the speakers would look at the constitution to say what it does instead of just trying to quote from large books or small books. That is not relevant. Kashmir is very much a part of India and will remain so. Article 370 was a temporary provision, and possibly that requires to be considered at this stage.
For the first time, yeah, okay, no, Ami Yagnik,
but let's not know that very thread that holds it.
Sameer, I want Ami Yagnik to come in now.
Mr. Goswami, can I ask?
No, Mr. Rana, after the Congress.
Go ahead.
After the Congress. I request you.
Can I have a word in?
Yes, I will come to you, Mr. Padgaonkar. Let the Congress have its say. It's coming in last into the debate. Simply put to Ami Yagnik, today tell Devendra Rana, just tell Devendra Rana that his party has jumped the gun. I know they are your allies, you have a bad relationship between the both of you right now. But regardless of that, why don't you just tell Devendra Rana that, you know, you should not be reacting like this, you are playing with fire. If the center has clarified that there is no process which has been initiated by the Modi government, it is not right of you to play with fire and use this as an issue to provoke sentiment in Jammu and Kashmir. Will you have the objectivity to say that today to the NC?
Arnav, first of all, they have their own mind and they're speaking what they feel like because they're responding to a minister's statement on the very next day after they take a place in office or oath in office. So this was absolutely not necessary to them, and retraction does not mean that the intent and motive goes away. So the party has
what's the intent?
And I may not be here to tell Mr. Rana
please
what
answer the intent and motive of Mr. Abdullah.
But looking to the nature of, but we look at Article 370 politically, procedurally, legally and constitutionally. It has a lot of complications and you have to look at it from all angles. So just coming and making a statement that they are going to abrogate 370 does not find any other meaning except that you want to say that you are going to spread this polarizing and divisive kind of propaganda which you already had there, and there is no development issue whatsoever. But speaking that as the Union of India, you are taking it across India and not leaving it only for Jammu and Kashmir. That is the main issue. Otherwise, the constitution has given a special status by way of Article 370.
No, don't.
We have to see.
Ami Yagnik, is it temporary or permanent?
Debate to see the.
Is it temporary or permanent? Temporary or permanent?
The constitution said this will be
whatever the nature. You have to follow that procedure.
No, what do you mean, whatever the nature?
And a special constituent assembly to come to that. You know, you can't just make a sweeping statement about Article 370.
So please tell me.
And say that you are having a motive of divisive politics here.
Who's dividing? The statement has been explained.
What is divisive about this? Are you including Kashmir or are you excluding Kashmir?
By the minister of the BJP incoming government. What was? No, this is the agenda.
How
there
is it
no development agenda. It was there from the very beginning.
Please explain the agenda of Mr. Abdullah. He's your ally.
You cannot afford to keep a full stop on this issue. Article 370 is an autonomous article.
You are not answering the question.
It has got a lot of complexities and complications.
You are just making allegations.
We have to answer. But this... There are not allegations, it's the clarity of the constitution.
What do you think about the statement of Mr. Abdullah? Is it divisive or not?
The state of Jammu and Kashmir has been.
Please give straight answers.
To the constitution. Your statement, your minister's statement has
What do you think about the statement of Mr. Abdullah? What is your opinion about that?
Yes,
statement?
And what do you feel about the statement of Mr. Abdullah?
Mr. Abdullah has responded. Mr.
Is it divisive or not?
To the statement of the minister, and he has said that let us have a debate on that. So you should have a debate on
this. Is it divisive or not? This is the only question.
Depths of the constitution.
Yes or no?
without going into the constitutional provision. You cannot make a sweeping statement about constitutional articles.
He was able to give a statement, but he has not tweeted like that.
No, bottom line is, bottom line, Dilip Padgaonkar.
No,
Dilip Padgaonkar.
Just a minute. Please read the preamble of Jammu and Kashmir Constitution.
Just a minute. What did Omar Abdullah say? 1 minute. So, no, Mr. I'm going to Mr. Padgaonkar. What did Omar Abdullah say? And Mr. Padgaonkar, this is very serious. Omar Abdullah says, mark my words and save this tweet. Long after the Modi government is a distant memory, either Jammu and Kashmir will not be a part of India or Article 370 will exist. I mean, Mr. Padgaonkar, what Omar Abdullah is therefore saying is that if Article 370 is abrogated, 1 minute, Jammu and Kashmir will cease to be a part of the Union of India. Jawaharlal Nehru, Mr. Padgaonkar and Sankarshan and everyone else, you will have to admit, Jawaharlal Nehru, I'm now going to quote, 27 November 1963, had said that we feel that the process of gradual erosion of Article 370 is going on. Some fresh steps are being taken, and in the next month or two, they will be completed. We should allow it to go on, which means the process of the erosion of Article 370. In 1963, Jawaharlal Nehru said that process is going on and should be completed. Today, Omar Abdullah dares, if I may use the word, he dares to say you take away Article 370 and Jammu and Kashmir will not be part of the Union of India. How is that not seditious, Mr. Abdullah?
You can't argue both ways, Arnab.
No, this is not arguing both ways. This is a fact.
This is
a fact. Let Mr. Padgaonkar respond. Let Mr. Padgaonkar respond.
Can I just please butt in here?
The bridge is being dismantled.
Mr. Padgaonkar, after that, Mr. Arnab.
Honestly, in this relationship is being on this program so far, Arnab, I feel there is an enormous amount of double speak going on all sides. You quoted Jawaharlal Nehru, you were right. You could also quote Gulzarilal Nanda, who had gone even further than Jawaharlal Nehru in this respect. All right, the fact of the matter is, the original definition of Article 370 of the powers that the center would have as regards Jammu and Kashmir and the situation today is completely different. Over the years, articles of the Constitution of India have been extended to Jammu and Kashmir. Indian laws have been extended. Some institutions from India have been extended. Some remain. So, in fact, this is called erosion by some. It's called integration by some others. So there is a lot of doublespeak on this hand. On the other, those who are saying all you've got to do is go ahead and abrogate. That is not going to be possible for a number of reasons. And the main reason is there are certain provisions, constitutional provisions, that you've got to respect. Certain guarantees were given to
a chief minister says, Mr. Padgaonkar, that if you have, if Article 370 goes, we won't be a part of India.
I don't want to get into
this. Is the kind of hyperbole? How can it be allowed
in the PMO?
Guaranteed to me by the Constitution.
One minute, Mr. Rana, hear him.
Let's go into the substance.
Well, I think your chief minister put out an irresponsible tweet. Yes, Mr. Padgaonkar, please continue.
Absolutely not.
Let Mr. Padgaonkar complete. Honestly, I can question you after that.
The last thing I want to say to you, Arnab, is... The last thing I want to say is that everyone knows what the positions of the stakeholders are on this issue.
Mr. Goswami, let me tell you on time now. You will be living or I will be living, I don't know. But time now will, the archives of time now will warn us all that we are playing with fire. It'll be fire, fire and fire.
I'll tell you one thing. I began by saying today. One second.
You are challenging the basic tenets of our relationship with the Constitution, which has been guaranteed to us by the Union of India. Through the Parliament
I
of
have
India,
a question for you.
Enshrined in the Constitution.
Take
of
away
India,
the rhetoric and let me ask you something.
Yes, please.
Record this. That should
yes,
be Article 370.
Yeah. So, just a minute, Mr. Rana.
And that anarchy is for everybody to be seen.
One second. Samir, before you come in, careful choice of words, please, Mr. Rana. Careful choice of words. Because it has already been said that there is no process which is underway. It has been clarified. The only person who wants to start a fire today seems to be Mr. Omar Abdullah. Yes, please.
As a member of the interlocutors team, is it true that a majority of the people, which includes, forget Ladakh, Ladakh wants a union territory status, majority of the people in Jammu and Kashmir, which includes parts of Jammu, actually want strengthening of Article 370 and not erosion? Is this a fact? I'm asking you this as a part of the interlocutors team, which went in there to every nook and corner to find out how. Is that not, are people not sensitive about it? You would know best. You've just been there last. Can you be honest enough to give me that answer, sir?
Well, I've always been honest, and I'll give you an honest reply. The fact of the matter is that we met more than 700 delegations in all the 22 districts of Jammu and Kashmir. And let me tell you, the political side of Jammu and Kashmir was the least discussed by these delegations. They were far more interested in issues of jobs, of prices, of good governance, etc., etc. Not that the political situation was not discussed.
How does 370 help?
But the preponderant discussions we had.
How does 370 help in good governance?
Secondly,
how does 370 help in good governance? Please tell me,
no.
Mr. Padgaonkar.
Please listen to this. Please listen to this.
Absolutely not. No, I was asked the question about whether people wanted strengthening of 370 or not. I said this matter really did not figure very high.
Yeah, you got the answer, Mr. Kaul.
The second thing which I wish to say is that there have been discussions. About 370 in Jammu and Kashmir. The two mainstream parties have come out with their proposals. These can be discussed. There are the extremists who want secessionism. They have said that they would also want to be part of these discussions. I repeat what the MOS in the PMO said. If he wants a debate on 370, we should have a debate. And all these people should be to be listened to, because there are sensitivities involved. Secondly, please understand, let us not be valley focused. The people of Ladakh have to be taken into account. The people of Jammu have to be taken into account. There are divergences even about political matters. So please keep these in mind. That's been reflected in all the reports of the interlocutors.
Sir, what have these elections shown? Samir, call one minute. You got your answer. Just because he's not giving you the answer that you wanted, doesn't mean that you say, you heard it. He's told you people are concerned about governance, prices, absence of corruption. And corruption is a big issue in Jammu and Kashmir. Now, let me say something to you, Samir Kaul. Hear me for now.
Kashmir is facing all these difficulties.
No, my question is, yes, Pinky Anand, I'm just coming to you. My point is, our parliament passed, India's parliament passed the Lokpal and Lokayukt Act in the winter session of 2013, right? I feel that in a state like Jammu and Kashmir, replete with corruption, maximum corruption, 20 cases of corruption against bureaucrats and politicians forwarded to the government since 2002, and God knows how many others are there. In a corrupt state like Jammu and Kashmir, because of Article 370, the people of Jammu and Kashmir are denied administration under the Lokpal and Lokayukt.
Article 370 has nothing to do with it. It is the dysfunctional Vigilance Commission, the anti-corruption mechanisms that the Omar Abdullah government is responsible for. And this question should be directed towards them. And Article 370 has nothing at all to do with it.
Commission, which is a very strong, robust body.
I'll tell you how robust the body is. Mr. Rana, get Pinky Anand back to the debate, but I'll tell you how robust you are serving the people of Jammu and Kashmir with what you are doing. You have your own right to information act.
We are debating 370, but now that you have digressed to Jammu and Janayuk, I just wanted to inform you that there's a state accountability commission and a state accountability commission act.
Not about party politics, Arna.
There is a commission working.
Which is lying dysfunctional.
absolute rubbish, Mr. Call. Absolute rubbish, Mr. Rana. I'll tell you why.
You have approached the government.
Mr. Call, just a minute.
There is an accountability commission
for corrupt
rubbish.
Ministers. You shielded corrupt ministers.
Mr. Goswami, there is an accountability commission.
We know how you deal with.
There is a state accountability commission act. Is that rubbish?
Now, Mr. Rana and Mr. Call, just calm down for a bit. Both of you, just stop for a minute. My question is,
Mr. Call possibly wants to
see how you dealt with
a debate for the elections. I can do that separately.
Not at all, Mr. Rana. This can't be your sing song all the time.
Mr. Goswami,
you have disrespected anti-corruption mechanism in the state of Jammu Kashmir, and Article 370 will stay. Whether you are there or you are not,
okay. Now I'm not going to reduce the volume.
No need to make an agitation out of it, because that's not how you're going to get people.
One second now, gentlemen, please, I'm requesting you. Again,
competitive election politics.
No election politics. I'll tell you the truth, Shankar Sen.
Absolutely.
Mr. Rana, please. Mr. Rana, I'm going to reduce the volume.
This is not a party political issue. Article 370 is not an issue between the PDP and the National Conference. Please understand this.
Absolutely.
I mean, Devinder Rana.
It's for the people of Kashmir.
Mr. Call, Dr. Call cannot be arguing about the relevance of Article 370. Please, it is not an election issue in Jammu and Kashmir.
A discussion. Please
Pinky Anand, please. Yes, Pinky Anand.
It is not, of course, I agree with
Pinky
you.
Pinky Anand.
It should not be.
Pinky
Anand. That's what the National Conference wants to
Sameer,
make.
Samir, 1 minute.
Thing, I think
Pinky
everybody
Anand.
Is rather unclear about and only to make out an election manifesto for the next ensuing elections. The point of view remains BJP's consistent stand has been that Article 370 requires reconsideration. Article 370 was made into a temporary provision which required reconsideration by the very terms of the Constitution. Kashmir became an integral part of India by treaty of accession, not only by the Article 370, which everybody is trying to make out. Today, the issue is not whether anybody requires.
No, let her complete.
Not. It does require discussion.
No. Let her complete.
The issue is there is no development in Kashmir. You don't allow the laws of this country to extend across the borders, excepting for defense and other important issues which have been excluded. The preamble of the J&K Constitution itself emphasizes that J&K is an integral part of India. Then why this desire for this heavy debate only excepting for political mileage?
Which I will tell you why.
No, one second.
Are they saying they don't want a discussion? Are they saying that this discussion process should not be on? All stakeholders should not be called? Or is it only going to be the threat?
No, Mr. Rana, please. Mr. Rana, please.
You are not even letting me speak on this program. I don't know why I'm here.
And get to know the facts about it. Let everybody put the facts before.
Yeah,
the
so
public.
Mr. Rana, let others also put
and
their
the
facts.
People at large should know the facts. There are certain myths and there are certain realities. The myths have been propagated, the realities have been kept under wraps. Let there be an open debate and let that debate
I'll tell you the reality.
The entire nation to know
what
are the myths and what are the realities. Mr. Rana.
Just a minute, Mr. Rana. Now, please don't speak over the others. Now, let me moderate this now, please.
This statement
let me now moderate this.
Can I just say something?
Don't try to make a big mountain out of it.
1 second. Yes, Sankarshan.
Arnab.
Mr. Paul.
Yes, Sankarshan.
I want to make
Sankarshan.
No issue.
Sankarshan.
Two or three points very calmly. I think I disagree with Pinky Anand. The BJP's position so far has been the abrogation of Article 370. In this manifesto, they took a much more realistic and reasoned position by saying that we shall have a debate on the need for Article 370. I thought, in writing, on paper, that was a much more reasoned position. So the BJP actually, in manifesto terms, has become much more reasonable. Having said that, on the first day that a government takes over, the minister in charge in the junior minister in the PMO comes out with a statement.
What are you discussing?
It is
are you trying to say that
the
there
party.
Is a proposal to revoke when the statement has been made
let me,
clear?
You know, I haven't had a word in all program. I haven't had a word in all program. Please listen to me for 2 minutes. Let me also say here, it is a Hell's Angels job to be Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir, no matter who it is. It is a very, very difficult job to do.
Is that what you're talking about, whether it's Hell's Angel or not Hell's Angel?
It is. I'm coming to why I'm saying this. Mr. Omar Abdullah is a politician. Like you, like any other politician, he needs to win elections or lose elections. He will say, He is speaking to a constituency.
So you admit he's politicized it?
He is speaking to a constituency. It is a very difficult constituency to maintain.
Please understand this, Mr. Rana. So let Sankarshan speak now.
If you do not understand this,
Jammu and Kashmir, and Mr. Omar Abdullah will stand for the people of Jammu and Kashmir.
That's all right. One second. I have one question. Unless you want to make a speech and not take questions.
Whether it is Wasim Ahmad Saeed or Omar Abdullah or whoever it is, it is a very difficult job to do.
Okay, so can I please ask both of you one question? Just a minute.
In Srinagar.
1 minute.
It is a very difficult job to fly the Indian flag in Srinagar.
Fine.
Let me say this.
Nobody is doing anybody a favor, please. Omar Abdullah is not doing the people of this country a favor.
India does not